Welcome all staff, students, families, and our community. My name is Toya Roby. I am KSD's principal. I don't have to tell any of you because you already know what a challenging year this has been for all of us. This is the first time our students are not going to be able to see Santa Claus here on KSD's campus. We felt that it was critical that our students still get to see him. The leadership team and I decided that it would be important for us to go somewhere. Where do you think? That's right, the North Pole. We are going to go and find, who do you think? Yep, Santa Claus himself. We are going to go find him for all of our KSD students. Our team is going to go search for Santa Claus at the North Pole. We have made plans while we're gone for some talented students to sign some Christmas songs for you and read you some stories. All of you sit back and enjoy and watch the show. Wish us luck. I sure hope that we can find Santa Claus in time. Now, I've got to get going and call my team. Oh, shoot. I got to go now. See ya.
Vroom, vroom. No.
Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were all nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out on the roof there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutter and threw up a sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, so up to the house, top the courses they flew, with the sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkle, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work. He filled all the stockings and then turned with a joke, and laying his feather aside of his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Merry Christmas from the Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. Christmas is a time of sparkle and shine. We give gifts with love and receive them with joy. We share with others and feast till we're full. At the first sight of snow, we rush out to play. And as the night falls, we wait in peace for the most magical moment. Merry Christmas.
Woo woo!
So, this story is called A Christmas Carol. Story is about a guy named Mr. Scrooge. Very rich man who lives in a town, and there's a lot of impoverished people around there. He doesn't have any family. It's just him living by himself. No family whatsoever. He's the kind of guy who's focused and dedicated on his work that he's doing. He's the kind of man who has the assistants come over and help him out in his house. Now it's Christmas Eve outside, and here Scrooge is, busy working, getting richer, getting meaner. His assistant's working there and is watching the clock. He's like, come on, it's time for me to go home to be with my family. And so Scrooge is, you know, he doesn't want to ask his boss, but he wants to ask his boss. He's, you know, can I go ahead and be off work? Is that all right? Scrooge looks over at him, says, very grumpily, if you want to waste an hour, Christmas Eve, that's fine. We can come back in on Christmas Day. He said, yep, said Scrooge. Fine. So he says, all right. He decides that he was going to go ahead and go. He gets his bag, his jacket, his scarf on. He's got some glasses. So he's getting everything, all of his stuff together. He says, bye, Scrooge. And he leaves. And here it is, snowing. The wind hits him really hard as he opens that door. Bitter cold outside. And here Scrooge is thinking, oh, it's cold as well. There's no electricity, mind you. And so here they are, lighting the lamps to keep warm. Scrooge diligently stays back to work. He's counting his coins. He's making stacks upon stacks of all his money that he has. All kinds of money. Pounds of gold he has. So now, when he's done with work, he gets bundled up and gets ready to go. He has his gloves on. Nothing's out of order. Everything's ready. He opens the door. And as he's walking, he sees kids out playing. They're playing in the snow and they're having a grand old time. So he continues on. He's not a happy old man at all. He gets to his huge mansion, a giant house. It is massive, but there's no lights on. Nobody's there. So he continues on, opens his door, and all the snow blows in on the floor. He forces the door back closed in the bitter wind. He gets up to his bedroom. He's changing into his pajamas, mind you. He's got his nightcap on. And there he hears the knock at the door. So he gets up to go check the door. And as he opens the door, he sees his brother. Happy to see him. His brother says, hey, it's Christmas. I want to invite you down to a party. Scrooge looks at him and thinks, no, I gotta work on Christmas Day. Ah, come on, what are you talking about? It's Christmas. Christmas is time to spend with your family. Come on. No, I can't go. There's no way. Nope, can't do it. All right. So his brother leaves. He's watched him go. Sees this big, ugly, this gargoyle there on the door. He's like, yeah, that's weird. That's something's not right about that. So he gets that out. So he's sitting down there at his fireplace, watching the fire crackling there, and he hears this bow, bow. He's like, what in the world? He hears it again, boom, boom. The house is almost shaking. He's like, oh, what in the world is going on? So he gets up, he runs around, locks all the doors he can. He, boom, there it is, the house is shaking again, and it sounds like something is going to come through the building. Two big, heavy metal desks. They're a boom. Every step it takes is making this booming sound. Boom. Through the house. So he's cowered. He's hiding behind the chair, cowering, not knowing what is going to happen. He hears the boo, boo, everything going on. And so, finally, breaks through the floor. And he's terrified at this point. Scared out of his wits. And he turns and he looks. He saw the second one. Here it comes. Boom! And there it is. Two indentations in the floor. And a man walks through the wall. He's a ghost. Doesn't have any, not many teeth left. He's got a uniform on, almost like a prison uniform. And so, he's terrified at the sight of this person that's here. He's trying to get away, but he can't go anywhere. He's backed up against the wall. He's like, what do you want? And here he comes. Hello, Scrooge. Do you remember me? I'm looking. Wait, deep down. Wait, aren't you? You're my partner. Yes. I've come to warn you that you will show, I will show you the three Christmases, past, present, and future. If you continue on as you are, what's going to happen? And it will be the end of me. And I will go to hell as it sees. And you will have to suffer your fate the same that I have. So they're walking slowly, terrified they are. Say, no, no! He's trying to grab a hold of his bed or grab a hold of anything that he can. Scrooge is hiding under the covers. But he hears the ball and the chains. He peers out. It's dark, really dark. No lights on. He's like, whew. His heart's pounding out of his chest. He says, no, 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 that can't be. No, nope, no, it can't be, it can't be. Tries to go to sleep, but all of a sudden, a light began to glow in his room. And as it got brighter, he peered out from under the covers to see what the light was. And he opened the doors, and it was a match. It was a match. It looked like it was happy. He said, hi, Scrooge. You know who I am? I am the ghost of Christmas past. Says, oh, you're so small. No, 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 this can't be. No, here I am. I want to show you the past of what Christmas was like. So where are we going? What are you talking about? Oh, we're going to take off. Let's go. No, I can't fly. You said you wanted to fly. I can't fly. There's no way. Don't worry. We'll use the magic. And off they went. Floating off of the floor he was. And they took out. I can't believe I can fly. And the light said, okay, well, follow me. Hold on. And then there they went. Flying all across town. Flying up and down the streets and over the building. Across the river. Through the snow. And there's a hole. You could see straight down through the fireplace of the houses that the fire that they have. Through the chimneys. And naturally Scrooge is coughing because there's a lot of smoke coming out of the chimneys. You know, they're going through the old town. You're following a train? Now remember, this is a long time ago. And they had trains. Anyway, the Scrooges, here they are. They're flying along. They're zipping through everything. And the light is just having a grand old time. Well, they arrived at Scrooge's old elementary school. And here they are. They wrecking right on the ground. Right on the floor. Scrooge got up and brushed himself off. Well, you see the light take off. But he didn't say anything. He just took off. And so, what are they going to do? What for? Close the room. It's been closed for a long time. And there's the teacher working. Everything seems to be going well. You can't take off. Just one lonely student sitting there in the room saying hi. No friends around. All by himself. And Scrooge says, huh. Why do I feel some sort of similarity here? Feels like I've been here before. And the light says, that's you. As a boy. Me? No, I was just a kid. Why was I so alone? That's because your mother and father, they didn't have any support for you. They didn't provide you with what you needed. You didn't have a friend. You were just there. So you decided to shut everyone else out. You weren't happy for yourself. You refused to let anybody help you out. Oh, no, no, no. No, I don't believe it. Honest truth, that can't be. That can't be. So, yeah, no, no, no. I don't think that, no. I can't look at this. I'm gonna ignore it. I am the man who I am, you know, now. No. So what do you mean? Well, the boy there, he's not happy. Look at him. Look how he's sitting. Sitting with his arms crossed. Just working, drawing away, no one helping him out. All of a sudden, the light was gone. In the blink of an eye. Oh, where'd it go? Light, where are you? It's dark out. What happens? What's happening to me? And here, the whole scene changed. Everything's changing. Wait, where am I going? There's trees. I don't understand. What's going on? It immediately, boom! The bright light came back. It shone right on him. It's like, oh! Here was a party. A big, grand party. Had lights, decorations, all kinds of music and food lined up for miles. Many people around that room. And Scrooge was recognizing some of the people that were there. Oh, there's my partner, my friends. Oh. He recognizes some of the ladies as my wife. And he realized, this is tonight. This is the night that I meet my wife. Oh. Wow. So he sees himself as a young man, a young adult. He's excited. He's there. He's ready to dance. He's ready to hang out with everybody. He's thinking, huh? I've never thought about this memory before. Never have I. So he's dancing with his friends, he's having a good old time, they're singing and cutting up and telling jokes and chatting and eating all kinds of food. And so young Scrooge is having a good time. He met a young lady there, which eventually became his future wife. And so they were a little flirtatious, and he was brave, young guy, confident, knew his stuff. So through conversation, they're hanging out, and Scrooge is thinking, huh. It came up again. So you miss your past, don't you? You miss your wife. Scrooge is scratching his head, trying to think of. He couldn't, honestly, he couldn't remember these memories that were being shown to him. So, are you ready? Yeah. I'm ready. I'm ready. All right. Well, we're going to go back to your office. And away they went, flying, whisked away, right in through the middle of town. They didn't stop, they just kept on moving through the buildings. Through everything. Scrooge, it seems to be getting hit in the face with all kinds of stuff and coughing. So he skids through the snow as they finally come to a stop, brushing the snow off of his face, cleaning himself in his clothes. He's cold. He looks up and he sees a sign to his office. Peers in as he opens the door. There's somebody working there, obsessing over their work, counting all of their money, wanting to go home because of Christmas. And Scrooge isn't having him. He's ignoring their wishes, and he's just counting away, working diligently. Because he's got to make that money and he's got to make sure everything is. He's rich still. Said, if I leave, you won't have anybody here left. Says, oh, I don't care. We're focused on the money. He obsesses over the amount of money that he has. Ah, poor guy. He gets upset. Says, bye, Scrooge. You'll never be seeing me again. And he's out. And there Scrooge is working away, saying, don't need him. So, Scrooge, it can't be. I can't believe that. There's no way. Say, yep, that's what happened. You obsess and you focus on the things that should matter in your life, but according to you, they don't. Says, no, it can't be. No, there's no way. I don't believe you. I can't believe what you're showing me right now. Well, if you don't believe it, then see for yourself. And so they sit down. And they're back in the bedroom. And as Scrooge is looking around, the fire is growing brighter and brighter and brighter. Looks like it's ready to blow. But there's nothing he can do. He covers up with the blanket as quick as he can, and immediately the fire goes down. He opens up his covers, looks, he's like, no, it can't be. This, no, this didn't happen. And immediately that door opens again. The figure shows there, right there in the light, shining behind it, shining underneath and all around his door. It's glowing bright. Scrooge wipes his eyes to make sure he knows what he's seeing. He's like, what in the world is going on? He comes in the room and he's looking around and it's full of gold and food and all kinds of things. You have a feast like Thanksgiving. There's turkeys and hams and all kinds of food spread out on the table. And looking up, you see a very large man with a big old beard, looking like a king, sitting at the end of the table. Looks almost like Santa Claus, really close to it, but he's the king. And he says, "Hi, Scrooge. I am the ghost of Christmas present. I am here to show you what's going to happen to everyone right now." And so there he is eating away, and Scrooge says, "All right." And then boom, the room starts spinning, the whole place changes. Scrooge looks around. And they arrived to his assistant's house. There's a plain wooden table. There's tools. And his family's sitting around there. And they're ready. And there his assistant is. They're ready to eat. They've saved. But he looks off. And the kids are playing and says, "Mom, you know, Mom is helping Tim." And so she sees Tim, and here he comes, walking in. He can't move his leg very well, so he's using a crutch as support. And he gets over there and gets seated down. His dad comes over, you know, ruffles his hair. And they're ready to eat. And there Tim is. He's coughing. He says, "No, I'm okay." Family checks on him. And they bring out this giant turkey. Steaming hot turkey. Everybody's mouths are watering. And they're ready to eat. And they have their Christmas feast. And Scrooge, he's focused on Tim. And asks, "What happened to Tiny Tim?" And the ghost of Christmas present says, "Well, what happened to Tim is because of his leg, he now has a disease. And in a few days, he's going to pass." And Scrooge says, "No, no, 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 what? What? That can't be. There's no way." Says, "Yeah, right now. Not right now, but in a few days, he will." And Scrooge is in disbelief. He don't think that'll happen. "No, it's not your assistant's fault. It's your fault. You pay him such little money, they can barely afford to have food. They had to save money in order to have food for Christmas." And Scrooge is saying, "No, you're lying. There's no way. There's no way that this is true. Mm-mm, I don't believe it. Not at all." So, here Tim is enjoying his food and coughing still. And the dad, not knowing what's going to happen, he just has a smile on his face. And Scrooge says, "No, no, 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 no. This isn't right. This can't be. I don't know how this can happen." Ghost of Christmas present says, "All right, I'll show you what's going to happen to your brother. Let's take off to his party." So they head over to that party. His brother's friends and family is gathered around. They're having a good time. They're just chatting it up. Their Christmas tree is decorated really nice. They're telling jokes. And they started to tease about Scrooge. And the ghost there of Christmas present, they're hearing all these jokes and they're laughing about Scrooge and making fun of Scrooge, really. and saying what a crotchety old man he is, and says his brother says, "No, no, come on." And Scrooge said, "No, that's not me. No, I'm not that way. Don't make fun of me." What? And then, the ghost of Christmas present says, "Well, this is what happens when you decide to focus on money and things instead of your family." And no. No, that can't be. No, I don't do that. And the ghost says, "Well, I'm just trying to show you what is happening. This is present. This is happening right now." So he sees everyone having their family and friends together on Christmas. He's realizing that he's all alone and wondering and asking questions. And boom! The hole opened up and he falls through the hole and he falls and falls and falls. He's screaming. Boom! And he lands right there on the bed. He's like, "Whew! Oh, oh man! Oh, I'm back! What happened? Oh my gosh!" And there's that hole that he just fell through. Whoop. Oh, holy moly. That scared me. Oh. So, oh no, there's another ghost coming, and it's the ghost of the Christmas future. His skin begins to crawl. He's not feeling right. The window, it's dark outside. The snow, his windows start to cover in ice. Oh. So there he is, getting his jacket on, getting his covers and blankets and everything. He's scrambling because he doesn't want this to happen. He's running as fast as he can to get away from this ghost that is coming. The ghost looked like the Grim Reaper. Looked like death is chasing him. And the ghost is walking slowly. And here he is, he's taking off. He's trying to go, and he comes to a cliff. He skids to a halt, and the ghost of the future doesn't say anything. He just walks up to him, and like nails on a chalkboard, finally, he's on the road. He's there. He's falling down. He doesn't know what's going on. He's running almost like Alice in Wonderland. It can't be. So he's taking off. He's running. He's kind of having an out-of-body experience almost in a way. Then that ghost takes his hand like a claw. He's like, "No, no, no, no." He sees a hole in a building and he ducks in. But that ghost reaches in and grabs him. He's fighting, trying to get away. He's making sure he's trying. He's like, "No, I don't want this. This isn't what I need." Keeps coming. It's growing larger and larger, and Scrooge is down in the hole and he can't get out. He sees a spot where he can't get out, and he's trying, he's climbing, he's yelling, kicking, and screaming. He's trying to work his way up the side of the pit as that ghost keeps getting closer. He finally broke through the snow. He was able to get out. Luckily, he didn't fall back in. But his head starts hurting. He hears the bells. Boom! The bells are ringing, and they're ringing so loud. The ghost of Christmas future, you can't see his head, his face. His hood's pulled down real low. He's walking really slowly. You just see his hands, but they look like claws. Scrooge is yelling, "Don't touch me! Don't touch me! Don't touch me!" And all he says is, Stop. He points. Scrooge looks. He sees a graveyard. So Scrooge takes the hint and walks over to the graveyard. Pushes open the gate and walks in. Now the graveyard is dark, kind of making him feel uneasy. He's walking along, looking at the headstones. He feels the ground rumble and he takes off running. He falls and hits his head really hard. And as he's groaning in pain and getting ready to stand up, he sees a tombstone. The lightning cracks. And he sees Tiny Tim. He scampers back. And he fell in a grave. At his name. He's like, no, no, this can't be me. Well, the ghost shows up and finally speaks. This is what happens to you when you are very greedy. You have no one to make you happy. If you decide to not be greedy, I will let you go back to the land of the living. If not, you seal your fate. Same as Tim. This will be goodbye for the rest of your world. And pushes him in a hole. He tries to fight back. He tries. He doesn't want this. But dirt starts to cover and fill the hole in. It feels like there's hands grabbing at him and he's trying to get out. He's trying to pull out of the ground. But the Grim Reaper just watches. As Scrooge begs and pleads, I will change my life, he cries out. And everything goes dark. And immediately he wakes up. And the light's coming in through the window. Scrooge gets out of bed. He throws open the window and over the curtains. He sees the snow and the sun. The newspaper delivery boy is out there giving papers. And Scrooge yells at him and says, what day is it? Oh, it says, well, it's Christmas Day. Scrooge says, oh, that's right. That means there's still time for me to make up everything. So without changing his clothes or just getting his jacket on, he takes off. He's laughing the whole time. He's having a good time running through town saying Merry Christmas to everybody that he passes. He's seeing all kinds of people. He's walking right past them. He's laughing. He's having a good time. He's tossing gold coins out and sharing the money that he has. He jumps on a sleigh or with some kids and he's playing. He's laughing. And he's running through town. And he arrived to his assistant's house. And he knocks on the door. His assistant comes and opens the door and says, oh, Mr. Scrooge, what are you doing here? I'm not supposed to be in for work. I'm not late yet. I was just getting ready. Scrooge says, oh, no, no, no. There's no need for that. Stay home. Stay with your family. But... And he gives him a heavy bag filled with gold coins. Shocked his assistant is, and he's very grateful to see the money. And he says, I finally realized that I don't need to be as greedy as I have been. That I need to share with those who need it the most. His assistant says, thank you so much. You have no idea what this will do for me and my family. He says, don't worry. Take care of Tim. And in that moment, well, I've never mentioned Tim before, but his assistant realizes, well, okay, thank you, Scrooge. I appreciate it. It's a whole no problem. But it says, wait, do you want to come in and join us for breakfast? He says, well, certainly, yes. So he joins his assistant there. They're laughing, they're cutting up, they're having a good time. Scrooge is playing with the children, and he's just having a great time enjoying himself. Tim's father is enjoying himself as well. And all the kids, and with Scrooge, and at night, they've played all day. So now, Scrooge goes over to his brother's house and knocks on that door. And Scrooge has a grumpy look on his face. And his brother's like, huh, well, come on in. Scrooge is kind of scowling, but his family suddenly has a grim look on their face, too, because Scrooge is there. They weren't wanting him to be there. They were just making fun of him. And so, immediately, Scrooge busts into laughter. And everybody else, he's saying, Merry Christmas. He's greeting everybody, and his brother is just kind of blown away with the way he's acting. Like, what in the world? But they have a good talk, and they're laughing, and they're cutting up. His brother says, whew, finally, I get our old Scrooge back. I'm happy for his old self to be here again. And they sing and dance and carry on and eat. And they just have a good old time with their party. When the party's over and it's time to go,
everyone. Hello. I just met Christy, Stu, Toya, and Joe outside. They came and they told me that they have traveled to the North Pole all the way from Kentucky. Wow! They wanted me to send you a video. Of course, I couldn't refuse. This year has been very difficult. Really, really hard. And I've been watching KSD. I've been watching all of it. And I've seen students, I've seen teachers, I've seen staff, families, everybody, each and every person involved with KSD, working incredibly hard. Wow, you all have done awesome, and I'm impressed. I am so proud of each and every single one of you. Ah, so proud. I hope that you all have a Merry Christmas. Now, I've got to go because I see some elves getting into my cookies. Hey, stop that! I love all of you. Merry Christmas.